not gonna lie, with this haircut, I do look like a Chinese version of Dora the Explorer. I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of true. I can kind of see it. Because it's really ugly, it is fashionable. Do you know what I mean? I get it, but I don't. Who did I actually think I was wearing this? I thought I was so cool. Yeah. I've been feeling so. Hi, hello, welcome back to my channel. So today's video, we are going to be reacting to my old outfits. So I picked a couple from when I was 4 to 6, I think, and some from when I was like 11 to 12. And we're just basically going to rate them, see what I like, what I dislike. I'd like to think my style has improved a lot. Some might argue otherwise, but you know, each to their own. Before we get into the photos, make sure to subscribe and turn on your post notifications. I post every Tuesday and like sometimes Sunday at 6 p.m. BST, and I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe. Okay, without further ado, let's get on to photo number one. So I'll put the photo on the screen now. This is the first photo, and there's a couple things I want to talk about in this photo. First thing that I want to start off straight away is this haircut. I feel like most Asian girls probably have had this haircut, you know, the bob, the fringe. I'm not gonna lie, with this haircut, I do look like a Chinese version of Dora the Explorer. I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of true. I can kind of see it.
Soy Dora, and this is Boots.
I feel like this is quite a mediocre outfit. Like, it's okay, but I've definitely had better outfits. So I have this yellow turtleneck, which I think has Mickey Mouse on the top, which is really nice. I also am wearing a pink dress, which has like a beaded flower going on at the front, and I think some ribbon at the bottom. And then I'm wearing a jade necklace, which I think really complements the whole outfit. So I feel like the outfit overall, I'd give it a 7 out of 10. I've definitely seen better outfits. It's not the worst. The next thing I want to talk about is the Hannah Montana cushion in the back of the photo. I know, you're probably so jealous of it. I honestly loved Hannah Montana as a kid.
It might be crazy, but we learn that way.
Next is my birthday cake. It is a High School Musical cake. I definitely went through a High School Musical phase, and this was kind of the start of the phase, I'm pretty sure.
Cool, a trip to the spa, endless days in my chaise, the whole world according to moi.
Overall, for the photo, I give it a 10 out of 10 just because of the Hannah Montana pillow and the High School Musical cake, but for the outfit itself, I'll probably give it a 7 out of 10. Next outfit is pretty much the same outfit as before, but it's got a couple of things added to it. So the first thing that I want to point out is this white fluffy cardigan jacket, which gives me very much Paris Hilton vibes, and it's very over the top. It's got pearls in the collars, which is very classy, and also a massive brown bow. I just feel like it definitely adds a little bit of flair to the outfit. They actually go down to my legs. You will see with the photos that I'll show you later that my parents, for some reason, are obsessed with dressing me up in thick, colourful pattern tights. I don't know why, but they are. I remember these tights, and they were my favourite tights ever. They're really colourful, have loads of hearts on them. Obsessed with them. Then we go down to my footwear of choice, and it's some pink, dirty crop. Now, do I think Crocs are fashionable? Not really. But do I think they're comfortable and practical? Yes. Yes, I do. I feel like overall, with the extra added things onto it, I'll probably give it a 7.5 out of 10 because, I mean, collectively did boost the outfit a lot more. Okay, this next outfit gives me very much I'm shy type of vibe, you know. I think I'm wearing a denim dress underneath, and I'm also wearing a pink jacket thrown over, which matches my black and pink tartan bag. And then we go down to my legs again, wearing some thick tights again. This time it's got some red hearts all over them and some trainers. So yeah, I think this is really cute. I honestly do. I definitely prefer this outfit than the last ones. I want to give it an 8 out of 10. Like, I think it's really nice. This outfit is a little bit questionable, I'm not gonna lie. So starting off, we are wearing some thick glittery tights this time, and the dress is cute. But I feel like a middle-aged woman would wear this pattern. Like a 50, 60-year-old probably have this pattern somewhere in the back of the wardrobe. It gives me that type of vibe, you know, like a very elderly pattern. You then have a Dalmatian bag, which I think I borrowed from nursery. I think this picture was taken at nursery. And I'm also wearing some white trainers. So I feel like overall, it is a nice outfit, but it's just not my personal favourite. So I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10. So first thing I want to focus on is the Christmas tree at the back. I don't know who decorated this Christmas tree, but I'm actually jealous because it's a really good looking Christmas tree. Now onto the outfit. I really like this outfit. I honestly do. It's really basic and plain, but I think the white and pink goes really well together. I'm wearing a white long sleeve top with, I think, a pink denim or corduroy skirt. Again, some thick tights. This time, these are white with, I think, purple ribbon going through them. And some really nice thick pink snow boots. I honestly, like I said, it is quite basic and it's quite a plain outfit, but I really like it. Also, I really like the little fur trimming at the top of the snow boot, really cute. So I'm gonna give her 8 out of 10. This next outfit is my all-time favorite outfit. We have a pink straw hat, we have a pink ruffled dress, and we have a pink purse, which I think says princess at the front. I love this outfit, I'm not gonna lie, it is one of my favorites. My mum did a good job dressing me up, so I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. I really like it, it's really cute. Okay, this next outfit is also quite cute. I think this is quite a nice outfit. So I have some hair clips in my hair. I think this is a cold. I'm wearing some joggers which has some butterflies and flowers embroidered onto them, and I'm wearing a sweater vest over it. I don't know why, but it kind of does add to the look. So I'm gonna give it like a 7.5 out of 10. Like, nothing too special, but it is a cute outfit. Okay, this is a cute outfit. I'm not gonna lie, this is adorable. So I don't know who gave this to me, but it's very, very iconic. All in red, which is a very traditional Chinese color. I know, it's really cute. I really like the fur trimmings, and it's just a really cute pattern. Again, thick red tights, and I'm also wearing some red socks as well. I'm gonna give this a 9 out of 10. Like, it is so cute, and it definitely, you know, brings culture and outfit. It's really adorable, and I personally love it. My lazy eye was very much activated in this whole picture. I'm wearing a cheongsam or a qipao, which is like a traditional Chinese or Hong Kong dress. It's red because red is kind of like the lucky color in the culture. I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10 for, like, you know, the culture. I think it looks nice on me, so I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. This is when it kind of like goes a bit iffy. This outfit. First of all, okay, there's loads of things I want to talk about. The top. I feel like because it's really ugly, it is fashionable. Do you know what I mean? I get it, but I don't. Why is there so much frills? Like, why is there so much, like, flowers? And there's, like, these frilly bits on the sleeves, which is okay, but, like, it's not really necessary. I don't think these go together, as in, I don't think it's a cold. And then we go down, I'm wearing the colourful tights again, and I'm also wearing these thick pink, kind of cowboyish boots with some flowers. I'm probably gonna give it 5 out of 10. Like, I feel like maybe separately would go well with other things, but I feel like all together it kind of clashes, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, so this is the next outfit, and I think one of my aunties or maybe a grandma got this top for me. It came with a matching bag, and I remember I wore this to, I think it was nursery or wraparound. I remember I got so many compliments that day, and I felt so special because it was like a cute jacket. I just feel like with the pink trousers, it don't look great. So I'm gonna give it a 6 out of 10 for this one. I put this photo in because I just want to show you the photo. I went to a park, and they had like loads of cute statues, and one of them was a piano. And my parents were like, "Just sit there and pretend you're playing the piano." But she probably won't be able to play piano when she's older. Let's just pretend she's playing a piano. Kind of, you know, make us proud a bit more. No, I'm just joking. This has been very stereotypical, but I feel like most Asian kids, if they played an instrument, it most likely would be a flute, a violin, or a piano, or maybe a guitar. I played the violin. Like, I honestly played the violin for a good 3 years of my life, and it was fun, but I didn't enjoy it. The lessons were expensive, so I was like, do you know what? I don't enjoy it. Let's just save our money quick. But this is the actual outfit. So it's, I think it's just a jumper, and I think the collar was quite a thick collar. It's got like a lace bear, and then it's got a velvety bear inside of it, which I think is really nice, a very nice contrast. I'm wearing some leather trousers, I think. I think about 7 out of 10. Like, nothing too special, but I just really like the bedazzledness happening. And also, I just really like the piano picture. I think it just made me chuckle. So we're gonna give it a 7 out of 10. Next photo is this one, which is my favorite photo out of all of them. It's so iconic. I feel like my diva mode was very much activated in this photo. Down at the top, we have a pink straw hat. We have some purple glasses. We have this kind of sheer mesh top with little flowers all over them, which this gives me very much Y2K vibes. Knee length trousers. I don't know what you call them. Just some trousers, wearing the princess pink handbag. And as you go down to my feet, I'm wearing some very pink bedazzled sandals, which Sharpay Evans could never. And I'm gonna give it a 10 out of 10. I just love it. I just love my little pose. I love the whole outfit. And yeah, 10 out of 10 for me. We're gonna go through my 11 to 12 year old phase. I'm actually embarrassed. Like, I'm actually embarrassed of the outfits I'm wearing these photos, because it's really embarrassing. First off, we're wearing a thick headband. I definitely went through a headband phase when I was like 10, like 10 to 11. We have the red small framed glasses, which definitely made my Asian eyes a lot more smaller than they should be. This is a H&M top. I was like, oh my god, it's so cute. And I think this is the first thing I ever bought from H&M. It's not cute whatsoever. I'm wearing a pink Hello Kitty bag. At the time, I wore these skirts and they were attached to a pair of leggings. And these were trending in China at the time. I definitely went through this phase of just wearing skirts and leggings and also some shorts and leggings. It definitely was a phase. The next thing is just some black boots at the bottom. 3 out of 10. I don't know what I was thinking. I feel like, okay, the colour palette's really plain, like the pink, the black, the grey. I don't know what I was thinking. It looked horrible. And I feel really bad for this person, the minion costume. I forgot about this photo. So I was 12, 13 maybe. And I was wearing this out. Who did I think I was? Who did I actually think I was wearing this? I thought I was so cool. I remember telling my mum, I was like, oh yeah, I have a cute outfit picked out. And I picked this outfit out. This outfit. Also, this is the time where I gained quite a lot of weight and I didn't realise until a couple years later. And I was like, oh, probably should lose some weight. Have this denim top, which I still have. We have this top, which just reminds me of Logan Paul and his whole Maverick parrot thing. Like, I only wear it to work out in. Skirt's so bad. Actually a terrible photo. It's so bad. Like, it actually is, like, honestly, it actually is quite bad. I want to give this photo a 3.5 out of 10. You know, like, I can see it, like, A for effort, but it just doesn't go well together. So I'm going to give it a 3.5 out. That is it for rating and reacting to my photos. Some of them were quite bad. Some of them were quite traumatic. Some other, like, other ones were, you know, top of the top. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!